Ja, välkomna vare sig ni sitter här I lokalen på Världskulturmuseet I Göteborg eller om ni sitter hemma framför datorn eller telefonen. Vi ska nu dra igång ett nytt programpunkt här på Globala torget på bokmässan I Göteborg. Den del av bokmässan där de verkligt stora, angelägna och svåra frågorna diskuteras. Nu ska det handla om ett land som det är mycket svår situation I Yemen och ett land vi inte hör så mycket om och också hur kampen för att få kvinnorna att ta del I besluten där. Och det är en organisation som ska göra det är Operation 1325 som ju är en organisation som just jobbar med kvinnors deltagande I fredsprocesser och konflikter. Så varsågod ordförande Lena Sundh, ordet är ditt.
Thank you very much and welcome to this discussion everybody. As you already mentioned, I'm the chair of Operation 1325 and with me today on the link from Aden we will have Samah, Yousef, who is political activist for women's political rights in Yemen and representing an organization called Mawada based in Aden. Mawada is one of our partner organizations in Yemen. With us also today we have Sofia Dohmen from Sida. Also on link, probably from Stockholm, I think. She is conflict advisor at Sida, at the Sida Department of Middle East and North Africa. She has also, in addition to what she's doing now, also experience from Colombia. As was already mentioned, our focus in general and in Yemen is the political and possibly also, of course, the peace process in Yemen. And I would like to kick off this discussion before asking my two partners to come in by making a very brief reference to the fact that the Security Council, about 2 weeks ago, held a meeting in New York regarding Yemen. And in that meeting, the new special envoy of the Secretary General, Hans Grönberg, participated for the first time. And why I'm mentioning this is because I think he made a very good definition of what he sees as his task given to him by the Security Council. He said, "I'm under no illusion about the difficulty of the task handed to me by the Council, enabling a resumption of a peaceful, orderly, and Yemeni-led political transition process that meets the legitimate demands and aspirations of the country's people will not be easy." But it's really this process that we are hoping for, and when hopefully that kind of process will start, then we want the women to be part of it. So now I will turn to Samah in Aden. Samah, in the events leading up to, and as well as in the national dialogue held in 2012-2013, women were active, visible, influential, and actually very successful in influencing the result of that national dialogue. But not long thereafter, war started. And looking now at the international efforts to end the war, we don't see any women involved at all. Even in Yemen, we don't see really that much of, in prominent way of women. So Samah, what happened to the women and to the achievements obtained in the national dialogue? Samah, please. Well, Samah, are you muted or is your microphone on? Okay, well, while we are trying then to get Samah, why don't I turn to you, Sofia? And to see actually what Sida is doing in Yemen and not least in support of women's activism, etc., women's rights. I know that the Swedish government at the end of 2020 adopted a new strategy for the Middle East and North Africa region, where for the first time, actually, Yemen was included and specifically mentioned, and there was even a frame for money-wise for Yemen. So my question to you is now, what is Sida doing, and will this strategy actually enable you to do more in Yemen? Please.
Thank you, Lena, and thank you, Operation Certified 25, for inviting me to this important seminar. So Sida's engagement in Yemen has until recently put a large focus upon the humanitarian needs of the country. In fact, the Yemeni crisis, considered to be the worst humanitarian crisis in the whole world, is one of the crises that has received the greatest support from Sida during the past 6 years. But Sida's engagement is also based upon the notion that humanitarian crisis in Yemen is mainly man-made. It is a result of years of political crisis and conflicts that has hampered the development in the country. So the only solution to this is a negotiated peace. It therefore needed to respond not only with humanitarian assistance, but also diplomacy and political dialogue, as well as with more long-term development cooperation. And as Sida, we have rather few programs working long-term currently, but the ones we have do have some very important results related to gender equality. Gender-based violence is the most extreme form of gender inequality, and it's a hinder to women's active participation. And a program supported by Sida in Yemen contributes to increased access to gender-based violence services, raised awareness on women's rights, engaging with community and religious leaders. And it also enhanced women's empowerment and participation in society through income-generating projects. And another program that we have that is very much linked to women's participation relates to a support on to a more independent and informative media in Yemen. And despite the challenges of being a journalist in Yemen in general, and a women journalist in particular, has this program challenged stereotypes of how women are portrayed in media through campaigns and promoting the participation of women in the Yemeni society. So to come back to your question, if the new development cooperation strategy for the Middle East and Northern Africa with an increased focus on Yemen will change anything, I will first say that it's a very important recognition to that building peace requires a long-term commitment. And this strategy is also an opportunity for SIDA to build up a larger portfolio focused on peace building, human rights, and access to services for sustainable development. And in all these areas, gender equality and women's rights are, of course, extremely important. So from my own experience working for 3 years in Colombia with the Colombian peace process, I have seen and I have felt and I have witnessed the importance of women's rights activists participating in the peace process. And I would argue that the most important Swedish contribution to the Colombian peace process is the long-term and flexible support to the Colombian women's rights organizations. And in order for them to build their capacity to meet and to strategize and participate as actors for peace. And these activities, they are very much like those activities that we will hear Samah talking about right now. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much, Sofia. So now, Samah, are you on now? I got some message that you should be online. Is that so, Samah?
Yeah. Excellent. I'm online.
Very good, Samah. So good to see you. And so then I will repeat my question to you then about what happened to the participation of women after their successful participation in the national dialogue, etc. Please.
Yes. In the national dialogue, it was the golden period for the women in Yemen. They participated by 30% quota. Each of the parties, each of the organizer, all of them, they support participation of women. And all the diplomatic also pressure, it was very nice for this participation. But when the war happened, and it was the situation, it was not secure at all. So most of them leave Yemen because of the situation. They cannot stay here because it is attack their lives. And also some of them they return to them and few works in the society like relief, like support other women on the ground and like that. And some of them, they are still fighting also for the human rights in Yemen, and they make a lot of advocacy.
It's not easy with with these links. They're fantastic, but when they work, but. So, Samah, I think she will actually come back soon because this is what happens. But in order not to just waste time, maybe I then will turn again to Sofia, because there is a particular challenge, I think, in involving women in Yemen. And that is also that there are two areas. The country is really divided between the north and the south. The government is in the south, and in north we have this Ansar Allah organization, which is also normally talked about as the Houthis. So while waiting for Samah, I'd like to ask you, Sofia, will SIDA and the activities of SIDA, supported activities of SIDA, actually be able to work, to function in the north, where the government is not in control?
Thank you, Lena, for that important questions. So just to start, that SIDA support, we seek as much as possible, we seek to take a whole Yemen approach. That means that we work both in the south and in the north. And as you rightly said, that in the north, the challenges are so much greater. We face bureaucratic obstacles, mainly in the north, that hinders our humanitarian and development partners to operate and carry out their work. And even more so if the organizations work on sensitive issues such as gender equality. So this is something that we continuously raise in our dialogue with both the Yemeni government controlling the southern part of the country as well as the de facto government in the north. Another way is that we have to adapt our activities to the reality of women and girls in these specific countries. So as a donor, we need, for instance, to recognize that in the north, merely opening a discussion on gender-based violence or women's political participation with community leaders, that is a critical achievement in itself, because the context in which women's rights are spelled out in the north are so much more conservative than in the south. And unfortunately, I must say that we do not see any positive trend, that rather recently the de facto government in the north issued a decree called Maram, and that obliged women and girls to always have a male companion when moving outside their home. So this not only restricts women's access to basic services, but it of course also hinders women from moving freely and engage in politics. So we have to be very, very humble in this extremely challenging context. And we do need a better analysis and a continued dialogue with partners, UN, NGOs, civil society, including women's rights organizations, as well as with other donors on how we can proceed. Thanks.
Thank you, Sofia. When we talked earlier on, we, of course, both of us said that the most interesting person in this discussion is Samah from. So feel a little bit now on the spot. Is there any possibilities that she can come in? Do we know what the problem is? Yeah, okay. Okay, well, so then maybe I can say, for, because I was going to ask Samah also what how now, because we have seen now that the women sort of disappeared from the stage after the national dialogue, or actually after the resumption of the war. I asked the Yemeni foreign minister when he was in Stockholm about what had happened to the women. Samah explained that many of them had actually left, etc. But the foreign minister, actually, I think he pointed out one thing that I think one shouldn't forget about also, that when the war restarted, the actors became those who were linked or closest to the arms. So even men from civil society, etc., were sort of a little bit marginalized, and of course women even more so. But what Samah's organization now is going to do, what they're working on, is to start an advocacy campaign with women, and doing that by interviewing a number of women about now if there would be a peace declaration from women, from Yemeni women, what should be there in that. And we are supporting that work, and we are hoping that that kind of work will mean that those organizations already active will be able to reach out to even to more. But we're also hoping that we can see some leadership in a campaign like that, so that women who take a leadership role will also have an opportunity to become visible, and also to practice, to learn more. So everything in order to try to help the Yemeni women themselves, because only they can do it, of course, to actually be so well prepared when there finally and hopefully will be a political dialogue, so that they can, with competence and self-assurance also, actually claim their role. Sofia, do you have anything to add to this? I'm really very sorry about our star here, not being able,
I can only fully agree. And talking about our star, I mean, this also shows a little bit about the reality of Yemen today. I mean, Sama's organization, Sama is one of, they're not all women's activists working from inside Yemen. And that is very important. And this whole problem with the internet, it's part of her daily life and probably one of the least important problem in her fight. So it's a little bit reality check for us. But of course, I mean, to give women a voice and a leadership and participation, that's something we know from conflicts elsewhere. And I mentioned Colombia was only one, but it's something that we really hope to support more even in Yemen.
Yes, thank you, Sofia. Actually, I said initially, and I referred to the new special envoy, how he had defined his task of actually enabling this political process that would then be a Yemeni process that would discuss the future of Yemen by Yemenis. I think it is important also to underline that the Yemeni conflict is a very multifaceted conflict. Outside of the region, we are aware of that there is a government and the Houthis. But there are, of course, other actors also important. And that includes even possibilities or what is happening on the ground in communities, etc. So one thing that we are hoping that the organizations that we are supporting will do also is to focus not only on the broad national scene, but also to try to see if it is possible to help women at more local level so that they become also enabled and stronger and also actually with more knowledgeable about what to do when conflict breaks out at the community level. There we know that this is an area where women have always been, but not generally not been given much credit for it. But I have been in various countries actually working and talking to women who are activists at the local level, and they are just doing it without actually knowing how unique in a way they are and the competence they got. So with that, I think I am terribly sorry that we lost Sama. But as Sofia said, it does also in a way underline the added challenges. Not only do they have to fight for their rights in a society which of course is very male-dominated, that it's no doubt about that, and even more so now in war times. But then when we are trying to link up and give some international support, etc., well, then of course everything depends on this IT. We had checked. We had a meeting earlier this week, and we checked, and so Samah is not just sitting at home, you know, like that. She had really undertaken quite a job to make sure that that her wifi would work, but still, it doesn't. So, with that, I think I would say thank you very much, and I apologize again for these technical problems. Thank you very much.